Alright, so we finally got home. It is now 6:30, and we're going to go ahead and cut these fish up. This is a big fish. But it's kind of cool because I can show you how to put the cheeks out. So I'm wearing the belly cam right now. Got the shoulder things down around my belly. So if you hear anything, that's my belly. Alright, so the first cut is behind this fin. There's a little bone that juts out this right behind there. Okay. I'm going to go in there. All the way up to the head there. Oh, you don't want to do that. So the dullest part of the knife is like right. It's right here. So you want to use as much of this part of the knife as you can to cut. So, let's see. Bump it up a little tiny bit. There we go. So, your first cut is kind of just getting through the scales on the top side of the backbone. Wow, I'm really botching this. Speed is obviously not important tonight. Alright, so you're going to just push the knife down. Pretend I didn't make that cut. You're going to push the knife down. You see that bend in the knife I have? Like that. You're going to bend the knife down and pull all the way back. And the point at which you're pulling, or your knife tip is just in as far as the backbone right there. See that right there? As long as you keep the tip of the knife there on the backbone, you're good. So that first cut was, again, just like this, into the backbone. Next cut is going to be up the backbone in this direction. And like, it's hard to show it, but if you push down with the knife as you're going towards the head, as you hear that, do you guess? Push down with the knife towards the head, it'll lay those rib bones down. Yeah, that's good, you can't even see, can you? Big hands. Alright, so then the next cut would be just out the other side. Normally I'd do that with one, but I'll show you how it's done. And there's actually a lot of meat up here. We call that the wing. I believe that's a cod tongue as well, but at any rate, out the other side, and you should have a nice, clean-looking, non-bloody fillet like that. And you know, that's something I never did, was bleed fish when I caught them. I don't know if it makes, it must make a difference, because this is a nice clean looking, I mean, it's not bleeding on me right now, so that's a good thing, eh? There we go, we're going to go down right there. Now, see, there's a bone that comes off of here, and there's another one that comes out this way, so you can just eliminate them now. If this was a valuable fish like a red snapper, I'd tell you how to get that wing off of there, but the thing is, it's just a lowly bluefish. Alright, so the scales are really the thing. So the closer you can get to the fin with, again, this part of the knife, the closer you can get down this way onto the fin, down that way, the less the scales are going to be an issue. So if you try cutting here, like up a half inch, you're going to have a hell of a time. But once you get it started in right near, as near the backbone as you can get, it'll ride right up. See that? And the scales just come off. A lot of times they'll come off, oh, they kind of are here in order. Like, you can rip all the scales off. You can have a stack of scales like that, if you do it right. And just doing it right is just a matter of getting all the meat off. So again, we're going to go into the backbone, up the backbone, and then down the backbone. See this? And go down the backbone this way. And if you press the bones down properly, you won't cut through any of the nasty stuff. You won't cut through the ribs either. That's it. It's kind of nasty looking. The green on there, but... Oh yeah, the cheeks. I gotta show you how to get the cheeks out. That's kind of cool. So, let's see, can you see it? Here we go. I'm gonna go in right here. And you just kind of walk the tip of the knife around. Okay, and then get that chunk of meat out of there, and always want to cut towards your fingers. No, I mean, no. Never cut towards your fingers, but it works out pretty well here. You can take the skin off. And you see how nice and light that is compared to the rest of the bluefish? That's why people say the cheeks are really, really mild, but I don't think it's any milder than the rest of the fish. Just a lighter color. Again, you just walk the tip of the knife through there. You don't want to cut into the eye. I mean, you can. It's not going to hurt anything, but it's kind of nasty. So my knife isn't steeled properly. Right, so... good stuff. Alright, so we're just going to put this over here. Whoa, real fast. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and rinse this off really quick. And then we'll skin it. And I'll show you quickly how to do it again. Alright, so again, if you're skinning and you're right-handed, run your knife away from, yeah, not into the board, but run your knife away from your last. So, like that. Alright, and the skin should come right off. So all of my pants that just splashed. There's real dark meat on the bluefish. Oh, that just hit my phone. Ah, I missed a whole bunch there on the, up here. That's too bad. The dark meat on the bluefish. Something this big, I'd cut it out. And I will cut it out. And something smaller, like those smaller blues, I'll leave it in. But to cut it out, you just run the knife down the center. Now, bluefish... it typically yields between 48 or 46 and 52%, depending on what's in the bellies. Which means you get a 10-pound fish, you're going to get 4.8 to 5.2 pounds out of it. That's what yield means, yes. So, you see all that dark meat there? I mean, it would be logical to take it off this way, but find it better to cut the fillet in half and then you can actually, let's see, cut it into chunks like that, because it gets a little bit, let's see, you're not even seeing, you're seeing my feet, turn this way, so you run the knife and I'm pushing down with it. Pretty good amount of force on the knife, kind of like skinning, to get that dark meat off. And very little light meat in there. You need to go back and do some more like that. So that's pretty good. That'll be a really great eating fish. You can put that on a plate next to flounder cooked the way I'm gonna cook it, and people would probably prefer to eat this because it has some flavor. Some people I know wouldn't, but they don't mind the flavor of fish. Like, you know, some people think tilapia is fishy. So don't try feeding this to them. Although, I've given it to people that just don't like fish at all, and they've actually kind of liked it. Depends how much spice you can use on it, too. But at any rate, so I'm just going to go ahead and clean this one large bluefish up. And then when I start cutting the other fish, the two smaller fish, I'll turn the camera back on. You can check that out. So that's one whole size. It didn't take me that long. And that's free of dark meat. Oh, yeah, there's my cheeks. And I got the cheeks. Alright, so I'm going to do the other side, clean it up, skin it, and when I start cutting the other two smaller fish, I'll turn the camera back on. Alright, so we got a decent amount of nice clean bluefish from that big fish. That'll be, you know what, I'll cook that one because that's going to be the strongest one, and I want to kind of prove how mild this stuff is. Like, yeah, obviously you won't be able to taste it, but this recipe is awesome. So here's the story behind the recipe. I had, when I was 15 years old, started at fish store, Bob Seafood in Haddonfield, and this lady would come in and she would buy, every time we had mackerel, she would empty the table. She would buy all the mackerel. And mackerel was bait for me. I'd never consider eating mackerel back then. And so this lady came in enough times. I was like, you know, what do you do with it? Why? How is it that you buy it every time you're in here? If we have it, you buy it all. What do you do that's so good? So she gave me this recipe. And to this day, it works really well on mackerel. There's that thing I was telling you about when you get closest to that fin there. It just goes right in. And there's a fair amount of bend in that knife. I don't know if you can see that. I'm really bearing down hard on it. But it's got to be the right angle. And again, it's not over here, so my fingers are in the board, right? I'd be on the edge. So anyway, to this day, any stronger fish, mackerel, shad, you know, this boneless shad that we get around here, it's an American shad. Yeah, it's boneless. That's all I've done it with. But mullet, mackerel, bluefish, anything that's strong, even eel. I mean, if you are so inclined as to try to eat eel. You know what? I'll put this over here. Right now, I'll get the other cheek out. Later, I think the instructions should be in the fillet. Alright, so right behind this fin right here. See that? Straight in. On an angle. See that? Towards the head. Then the tip in right there. Find the backbone. Keeping the knife on a very, very slight angle towards on the backbone. Just draw the knife backwards. Oh. past the backbone. There we go. Over the backbone, up the rib cage, on out the other side. Hey, you see, you don't want that. Get the guts in there. So, my phone case smells absolutely terrible like fish. How much to put that in your pocket for a whole day? If you like me, would you do it? How much would it cost? You're and your friends, go partying at night. Go to a bar, go clubbing. What do you think? Would you do it? Probably not. I will go clubbing. Alright, so that's it. There's the fillets. And the skinning, like I said before, you don't want to chase your stuff around on the table, so rinse it off. Nice and clean then. Stay away from your last. See, now here it really doesn't matter if you get all the skin, because we're going to go back and cut it. Cut the dark meat off after. That's pretty good though. Although these small fish, they probably don't really need it the way I'm going to cook it. So I'll just cut the bones out. Now the bones don't run back that far, but some dark meat in the center there, we'll just cut that out. And trim the fin. Again, I'm pushing down on the knife. There's a really steep bend in it. Like I can cut off a micron. Just push down on the knife. As long as your edge is right, it'll come right off. Phone just died. I have no idea what you guys are seeing. Pushing really hard down on the knife. You can get a really thin. I just realized that sound must be horrible on YouTube. It's a Tony Bamboni noise. I do apologize for that. I apologize to humanity for Tony Bamboni, is that his name? I don't know. It's just terrible. So, that's about it. So, we're going to go ahead and clean the rest of this up. We'll portion these out. Yeah, we'll cut them. Half pound portion, so that's probably, well, I'm gonna trim the dark meat off, so that'll probably be about a half pound. That piece will probably be a half pound. Not really, but that's what it's gonna be. Not bad. We got some good fresh fish today. We took care of it, we put it on ice real fast, and we're gonna make some people real happy. Some people that I haven't had bluefish. That was bad. Haven't had bluefish in a long time. I grew up on this stuff. The big 16-pound bluefish from North Carolina. Scaled, head off, fins on. Brought home 3 days before the end of vacation in a cooler. So in a cooler for 3 days, not frozen. Then frozen in aluminum foil. And throughout the year, we would have Dad's bluefish chowder, which was potato soup with a green foam boiling on top of it. We lived in the working part of Haddonfield, and if you didn't eat it, you'd go hungry. So that was dinner. Deal with it. That's what we did. Never really cared for it. I mean, bones and fish scales in soup should not be. At any rate, I'm going to go ahead and portion this out, and the next time you'll see these fish, we'll be marinating them. Thanks for joining me, and hopefully you don't demolish fish after this. Hopefully this tutorial might help some people, but probably not. Well, I hope it does. I had a good time doing it. See ya.